It was an announcement few were expecting.
I hereby announce my resignation as Prime Minister from the Lebanese government, knowing that the will of the Lebanese is stronger and their determination is steadfast and will overcome any attempts to impose any custodianship over them from powers either inside or outside our country. Long live the people of Lebanon.
Saad Hariri's resignation was made from the Saudi capital, Riyadh. In a televised address, he also sharply criticized Hezbollah and its key backer, Iran.
I would like to say to Iran and its followers that they will be losers in their intervention in the Arab affairs. Our nation will wake up, as it did in the past, and their hands in the region will be cut off.
Hariri became prime minister in late 2016 in a compromise deal under which Michel Aoun, a political ally of Hezbollah, became president. The agreement ended 2.5 years of political deadlock in which the country was without a functioning government. And while Hariri's surprise decision to quit raises more questions than answers, it puts into focus the regional rivalries Lebanon often finds itself at the center of. The leading Sunni politician is backed by Saudi Arabia, while Hezbollah, Lebanon's most powerful political, social, and armed movement, is sponsored by Iran. Despite the complex nature of Lebanese politics, the 30-member unity cabinet appeared to be functioning. Until now.
It's a coup by all measures, and it's like an invitation to instability into the country. Everybody was working for a program to rebuild the country economically, politically. We have an election. There is a cohesion within the government. There is agreement within the political party. We've been working beautifully. And then a phone call will come and change the whole calculus of the politics in Lebanon.
In the past 5 days, Hariri has made 2 separate visits to Saudi Arabia, where he lived in self-imposed exile following the collapse of his last government. There, he met with Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman, who is known for his aggressive stance against Iran. U.S. President Donald Trump's administration is also pursuing tough policies on Iran and its allies, including recent sanctions on Hezbollah. Hariri's resignation comes as the war in neighboring Syria appears to be entering a new phase. The government of President Bashar al-Assad, which is backed by Iran, is increasing control over larger parts of the devastated country. And it's feared that tensions, which have been simmering inside Lebanon since the start of the war between Hezbollah and Israel and elsewhere, could not only reemerge, but has the potential of escalating into a major conflict. Imtiaz Tyab, Al Jazeera, Beirut.